Bang, bang. You shot me down, Umar. Bang, bang. You hit me in the ground. Bang, bang. That awful sound of me bringing this reaction to you late. Bang, bang. I'm gonna shot this reaction. Shoot this reaction down. Uma Thurman, Kill Bill 2. Let's go. Yes, guys, how you doing? Welcome to Josh Dross Ash. We are back with Kill Bill 2.
You and I have unfinished business.
Ooh, let's go.
I went on with the movie advertisements refer to as a roaring rampage of revenge. I roared and I rampaged.
God,
that bloody satisfaction. I've killed a hell of a lot of people to get to this point.
Goosebumps. Goosebumps.
And when I arrive at my destination, I am gonna kill Bill.
Oh! Are you mad? Is this how you're gonna start this? Is this how you're gonna start this? You're gonna break that fourth wall? You're gonna obliterate that fourth wall? You're gonna look at me and tell me you're gonna arrive at your destination and kill Bill like that? With your suit on? Driving with no roof? Is this how we're gonna start? Umar, what are you doing to me, Umar? Umar, do you want my neighbors to kick me out? Do you? No, you don't.
You may kiss the bride, but don't stick your tongue in her mouth.
Imagine on your wedding day, sticking your tongue deep down your girlfriend's throat. Like she's going for, like everyone's like, look how beautiful they are.
You may kiss your bride.
Really?
Yes.
Ah, in her mouth. Samuel Jackson.
Let me tender be great.
Rufus, he's the man.
He's gonna start doing that Stevie Wonder.
Honey, you know, it would be good if you had somebody come.
You know, oh, that somebody's gonna come. That somebody's gonna come.
I don't have anybody. Except for Tommy and my friends.
You have no family?
Well, I'm working on changing that.
All right, man, this fucking girl, you have no facts. She told you once, bitch.
This moment, I'm looking at the most beautiful bride these old eyes have ever seen.
Does Uma Thurman in this movie have daddy issues? That guy is a bit too old for her, right?
But I'll do my best.
Him, like, calling her kiddo and stuff?
However, all cockblockery aside, I am looking forward to meeting man.
You want to come to the wedding?
Only if I can sit on the bride's side.
Tommy, I'd like you to meet my father.
My father? Oh my god. The disrespect. She didn't even just friend zone him. She family zoned him.
Pay so much money for a dress you're only gonna wear once. Especially when Arlene looks so goddamn beautiful in it.
Oh, look at his face. He's getting jealous. He's like rubbing her back while he's complimenting her.
Isn't it supposed to be bad luck for the groom to see the bride in her wedding dress?
That jealousy. Look at his eyes.
I guess I just believe in living dangerously.
Wrong words.
Really, have a seat.
Which is the bride's side?
Right over here.
God, the tension. Even though I've seen this scene, like not obviously this actual scene, but like the end bit, it's still like, I know what happens. It still like makes you nervous. Like the way he delivers his lines, like Bill delivers his lines. It's so powerful. Like the way he looked at him and he went, which side is the bright side? And he just kept staring at him. Like, fuck, man. This is like from a Clint Eastwood.
What the hell?
You can just hear Samuel Jackson. What the hell? Fuck, man.
start becoming afraid of you because she is coming, and she's coming to kill you. And unless you accept my assistance, I have no doubt she will succeed.
I don't dodge guilt, and I don't chew out of pain my comeuppance. That woman deserves her revenge.
Wow.
We deserve to die.
You see, that's what makes him so dangerous, because he has nothing to lose. And he's like, listen, I'm here. She can kill me if she wants, but I'm going to obviously defend myself. But I couldn't care less. She deserves it. Like, he's ready for it. He's accepted that that's the life that he picked. But he also has nothing to lose, because he's living in a fucking trailer. And he's probably shitting around the side of it as well. So, like, the guy has nothing to lose. That's what makes him so dangerous.
The reason that you're not doing the job that I'm paying you to do is that you don't have a job to do.
Why is everyone talking like this? Why is everyone talking like this? What's going on? This guy is wearing a wig. You shouldn't talk like that if you're wearing a wig, you fucking prick. Don't wear a wig.
That fucking laugh. How many times have I told you? Don't wear that fucking hat.
Fucking shoot this prick.
Customers wear hats.
Not the boss of the customers. I'm the boss of you.
This, I'm telling you, this guy.
Keep that shit kicker hat at home.
Yeah. Take your hat off. Get serious on him. Fucking stab him. Where you going, man? You're an assassin. You can't just let him talk to you like that, bro. Why wouldn't you just dress all in black? Why do you have a mask on that is black? I love the fact that she, like, doesn't use a gun or a sniper. Like, she could have just shot him on that hill, right? But she gets up and personal with people. She wants to look you in the eyes and fuck you up, right? Like, she doesn't want to go through the whole bullet. That's too easy. Oh, I think he's ready for it, you know? I think he knows that she's here somehow. Listen to that guitar. Boom! Oh my God. Oh my God. You can't bring a knife to a gunfight, man. You just can't. I told you he's the most dangerous one because he has nothing to lose. He ain't scared of you, bitch. Oh, listen to this music.
Hang on. Tits. Fine. As big as yours. Can't even imagine how bad that shit must stay.
Oh my God, the disrespect. Oh my God, this guy. He's... Uma Thurman just killed like 97 people in a movie. And he just spat on your face and literally disrespected your tits. What's he gonna inject? And he's injecting you in the ass as well? Buddy, can I tell you something? I'm sorry, Uma, you're not my favorite. Buddy is.
I just caught me in the cowgirl.
Just like that. He just sat there and he went, bang, your samurai Hanzo sword that he was like literally praying to. He was like, ain't, listen, you can't. Shotgun, done.
What's the terms?
Well,
you
know, you
get your bony ass down here first.
Bony ass! First you disrespect her tits. And now you calling this girl pancake ass? Her flat iron ass? Buddy. I'm getting a t-shirt of Buddy. Do you understand? favorite character. Blonde pussy, oh my god, this guy. He would get cancelled in 10 seconds if he was living now.
You got anything to say?
Oh my god, he's gonna bury her alive.
You're going underneath the ground tonight.
Oh.
That's all there is to it. You know what's it gonna be, sister?
Not get buried alive, if that's okay, mate. I don't want to... Fuck me, man. She's been through so much. And she only gets a torch? Imagine hearing that sound of you knowing you're about to get buried alive. And just seeing that light shine through on the corner as well, seeing that last like fresh air, that is so scary, man. There's no way. Like, how are you gonna get out of it? She must be thinking, like, was revenge actually worth it? Like, was all of this, is it really worth it? Shall I just die here? Or shall I fight? You know what I mean? Like, she came out of coma. She did all of these things, like, getting buried alive and being shot in your tits as well.
When will I see you again?
That's the title of my favorite soul song of the 70s.
What?
Nothing. When he tells me you're done.
When do you think that might be?
That, my dearest, depends entirely on you.
Look how innocent she is, and how, like, she just listens to his every word and is so captivated by him.
Hates Caucasians. Despises Americans.
Wow. Look at his eyebrows. This guy's got his eyebrows on fleek. Literally, that's what happens to my Middle Eastern eyebrows if I don't trim it. He reminds me of Jackie Chan's drunken master sensei. He's paying a homage to like the 1970s, 60s Chinese martial arts movies. Oh, he even captured the setting as well, like the way he's just sitting on that place and just so disrespectful and just looks down on you. Disrespectful. Taps on the shoulder. Disrespectful. Oh my god. Lands on a sword. This, how strong is she to hold him though? God, you can't even catch his throat. His balls are made out of steel, this guy. My man doesn't have blue balls. He has rock hard balls. Oh my god. It's my arm now, I can do what I please. I would have said something like, yeah, but worms eat eagles when they're dead. And he would have just ended my life there. This wasn't training? This is the pre-training to the pre-training to the warm-up to the pre-warm-up. I would have told this guy that Bruce Lee told me.
or don't hit back.
He would have ended my life again. Look at her skin peeling off as well. Oh, the little details. Look at her. Let me try this. Do I have something? Let me try my wall. Fuck. Oh, even in her sleep. Can't even eat the food, man. I love these details. Like, any other movie would have cut this bit out and would have gone towards the end where she, like, starts to know how to fight. These little details mean so much.
You got to hold your gun at your home's here. What do you hold your gun at your home?
Oh, mate, come on. You can't throw that rice away, bro. That's a really good lesson. Like, you need to endure the pain. Like, your pain threshold, you can't give up that easily. Like, one grain at a time, you know, one step at a time. That is such a great lesson. This is what it's showing you. Like, you can overcome getting out of a coma. You can overcome getting out of, like, hopefully she gets out of the grave. You know, it's just a tiny lesson that has such powerful meaning. Yes, look. You remember what she said about her toe? She goes, wiggle your toe, one grain at a time. Let's go. Let's go. Okay? 1 centimeter at a time. Get out of this fucking grave.
Sir! That looks like quite a fun toy. Grab me that mouthpiece!
Wow. Close your eyes before it goes in your eyes. How is she getting out? Casually, she's so badass. She just goes, she walks in and she's so tired, but she is still so polite. She could order, like, mate, if I was her, I'd be ordering like 10 tequila shots, a milkshake, some pancakes, sausages, eggs. She just ordered a glass of water. Are you mad?
What's the name on the grave she's buried under?
Paula? Short.
You know Tarantino has like all these little signs in his movies, right? I've seen Django, and Dr. Schultz was probably like in 1800s, right? With Django. Isn't that like a little reference to Django? Like, obviously this film came before it. Is this like a little reference to that movie? Do you think? It has to be, right?
So now that you're not gonna have to face your enemy no more on the battlefield, which are you filled with relief or regret?
Oh! Shit! Oh! Shit! Oh! This is why Uma Thurman's hurrying up, because like all these assassins are just killing each other if she doesn't do it.
Bud, I'd like to introduce my friend, the Black Mamba.
Black Mamba.
The venom of a Black Mamba can kill a human being in 4 hours if, say, bitten on the ankle or the thumb. However,
you've been bitten on the face.
Or torso can bring death from paralysis within 20 minutes. Now you should listen to this because this concerns you.
Oh, she's just so disrespectful.
Not treated quickly with antivenom, 10 to 15 milligrams can be fatal to human beings. However, the Black Mamba can deliver as much as 100 to 400
this
milligrams.
This bitch has got 4,000. Imagine hearing her reading this out while you're dying.
Let me answer that question you asked earlier more thoroughly. Biggest R I feel is regret. Regret that maybe the greatest warrior I have ever met her end at the hands of a bushwhacking, scrub, elky piece.
He's the greatest warrior.
Like
he literally shot her.
Look for the headstone marked Paula Schultz and lay them on the grave, because you will be standing. Final resting place of Beatrix Kiddo.
That's her name, Beatrix Kiddo.
Here. Look. I can meet her in about.
This is some fetish daddy issue thing, man. Uma Thurman with her ponytails and claws. And her name's Kiddo. Oh! Oh my god, what's going on? You can't bring a long sword, bitch. Boom! Oh! Stepped on her toe. Wow, that's like... Oh my god! This girl looks like the type that she likes it rough, so don't choke her. She might be into that shit. She might be into this shit.
Something I've always been curious about. Did you say to Pai Mei to make him snatch out your eye?
Oh, Pai Mei snatched her eye out. Oh my god.
Miserable old fool. I killed that miserable old fool.
Oh my god, she killed him.
Fish head. Miserable fool.
Well, to be honest, Pai Mei, you shouldn't have got her eye out, mate. Like, she's trying to learn martial arts. Just, like, let her go. Why are you taking her eye out? Oh my gosh, she's gonna fuck her up.
And now I'm gonna kill you too. With your own sword, no less. Bitch.
Bitch.
You don't have a future.
Let's go! Let's go! You don't have a future, bitch! Holy shit! She did all that research on that Black Mamba, but you didn't do your research on this bitch. Caught your eye out. The irony. Research a Black Mamba and you get killed by a Black Mamba. She seems more like the way she's screaming. I think it's less to do with the pain, but more to do with the fact that her life is over. She can't see. Her little R should be she can't read. Dead joke, but true. She can't read. Hey! Mi amor! Come on. Hey!
amor. Only on the condition that you call me Esteban.
May I join you, Esteban?
Please.
May I join you, Esteban? God, Spanish accents are so sexy. They could make anything sound sexy. Like cucumber, right? I say cucumber, Spanish.
Cucumber.
Tomato.
Tomato.
I must warn you, young lady. I am susceptible to flattery. How may I be of service to you?
This guy blinks so slowly. Is he high? Or is he in slow motion?
My pussy wagon died on me.
The pussy there. Being chucked you in the head, no?
Yes.
It would have been much nicer. It would have just cut your face.
Oh, thanks, mate.
Clara!
Oh, imagine calling your girlfriend like that. But it's so sexy that you're like, sure, I'd make you whatever you want. Oh, look at her face! Garcia. She doesn't even care because of his accent and the way he blinks slowly. She's like, Garcia. Oh, God, the choice of music in this.
Freeze, mommy.
Bang, bang.
Oh, shoot. That is so sadistic.
Hold down, sweetheart. You shot us.
I'll shoot you down. Oh my God. Bang, bang. This is all coming around. The play on words here.
BB.
BB. I should have known. You are the best.
The emotion. She went from being so angry to being playful for her daughter to also showing pain. Like, how did this woman not win an Oscar? Do you know how hard that little scene was? Do any of you understand? You know, when this is all coming back, right? Like, this scene with her daughter reminds me of the scene with Vanessa Green when she saw her daughter come in and her facial expression completely changed. Like, she went from, like, full rage to, like, calming down and pretending that everything's fine. Uma Thurman just got the same thing.
And put him.
Like, she was coming here to blow his head off. And now she's, like, eating sandwiches with the kids. This is genius, genius writing.
Shut up, mommy. Not pretend shooting like we were just doing. I shot her for real.
Whoa!
Why didn't you want to see what happened?
No, I knew what would happen to mommy if I shot her.
Whoa! That is not a bedtime story. You can't say that, bro.
What happened?
I was very sad. And that's when I learned. Some things, once you do, they can never be undone.
Yeah, because you shot her in the head. Imagine reading that bedtime story to your kid. Yeah, I shot your mom in the head and then... Fuck, man.
Which one do you want to watch?
Shogun Assassin.
No, BB. Shogun Assassin is too long.
Mm-mm. That would be my kid, right? There'll be like Peppa Pig. There'll be SpongeBob SquarePants. We have, Tom and Jerry. My kid would be like, Enter the fucking Dragon.
Well, it just so happens I have a solution.
Ah! Gotcha. Oh, shit. Ah! What? Where did you get that?
Incredibly potent and quite infallible truth serum. I call it the undisputed truth. Superman didn't become Superman. Superman was born Superman. When Superman wakes up in the morning, he's Superman. His alter ego is Clark Kent.
His outfit with the... Wow.
That's blanket he was
Kent wears, the glasses, the business suit. That's the costume. That's the costume Superman wears to blend in with.
The writing in this is literally sex. It's just so good.
And what are the characteristics of Clark
Kent? He's weak. He's unsure of himself. He's a coward. Clark Kent is Superman's critique on the whole human race.
Wow!
Beatrix Kiddo and Mrs. Tommy Plimpton.
So, the point emerges.
So this guy, like, groomed her.
Did you really think your life in El Paso was gonna work?
No! But I would have had Bibi!
Don't get me wrong. I think you would have been a wonderful mother. But you are a killer.
He does have a point.
Why did you run away from me with my baby?
Because you're too old, bitch. You're about to die.
What I didn't know was that somewhere on my journey I had been spotted. So, can you just leave it by the door?
Oh, shit! Oh, that's so cool!
Karen? I just found out that I'm pregnant.
What is this?
I'm the deadliest woman in the world. Right now. Use, remove the cap and urinate.
God, the tension in this, her reading the small print. Myself, thank you.
Okay. Let's go home. I'll do the same.
Congratulations.
I was a killer who killed for you. Before that strict turn blew, I would have jumped a motorcycle onto a speeding train. But once that strict turn blew, I could no longer do any of those things.
Wow.
Well, why didn't you tell me then instead of now?
Once you knew, you'd claim her. And I didn't want that.
Yeah, he will bring her up into this fucking assassin world.
I was trying to track down the fucking assholes I thought killed you. So I find you. And what do I find? Not only are you not dead, you're getting married to some fucking jerk. You're pregnant.
I see his point. I really do see his point. Like, all you had to do was just communicate. It's just two lovers who overreacted in their decisions. That's what this movie is all about. Like, they can't communicate properly as they're doing now. So they just overreacted so badly.
Was my reaction really that surprising?
Yes.
Yeah, but if you really loved it, why didn't you just talk to each other, both of you? Therapist Ash.
You and I have unfinished business.
Boom! Oh, shit! Oh! Oh, shit! Just went in! Bad! Broke your heart, bitch! Broke your heart! Bitch! Broke your heart!
Plan A taught you the 5-point palm exploding.
Yes! I'm her best student!
You're not a bad person. You're a terrific person. You're my favorite person. But every once in a while, you can be a real cunt.
Carl. I would have thought he'd be like, out of all the deaths, right? Like, they're all being so dramatic with the blood, like, and like the eye thing. I thought his heart would just literally explode out of his chest. That bit was a little bit disappointing, the way he fell. Like, if you're gonna go full dramatic, like, at least have his heart just come out of his body or something and explode. You've done it, man. You've done it. One grain at a time, one wiggle at a time. You've done it. You've fucking done it, man. Mi amor, te amo. Mi amor, te amo. Uma Thurman, mi amor. Wow, what a movie, man! What a movie! Listen, as much as we watch this movie and we crave the action and the revenge, there are some great lessons, okay, that I would say I've learned from this movie. First of all, if you're in a relationship, communicate with your partner. Don't exaggerate your problems. Okay? That's one. Number two, if you have a goal in your life, okay? Now, this goal that she had was revenge. I'm not talking about killing people, okay? Or getting revenge. What I'm talking about is any goal you have in your life, right? Don't you fucking dare let any obstacle stop you, okay? And your boy's being serious right now, okay? I had my dream of starting this review reaction channel, and I've finally done it, okay? Whatever goal you have, one grain at a time, one wiggle at a time, okay? Don't ever give up, man. Like, it's been said so many times, these things, but it's so true. Like, if you look at this movie for entertainment, you enjoy it, right? But if you also take this movie as a lesson as well, like, as fucked up it is, this movie is, it just shows you, no matter, like, how, if you want that shit, if you want to kill Bill that bad, you could do it. If you, now imagine your dream is kill, is Bill, okay? All you have to do is just go through these obstacles that's going to be in your way and expect those obstacles, okay? Make sure you get there. And when you get there, you're going to be like, you know, Beatrix on the floor crying because you've achieved your goal. That's why I love this movie, man. I mean, the kills. Now, let's talk about the movie. The kills, amazing, so satisfying. The script, oh, like, every line in this is just a pure, is perfection, okay? Uma Thurman, again, her delivery, her lines, like, her facial expression, she went from so many different emotions. She saw her daughter being alive after this long time, right? And she goes through, like, she starts, she's getting it, right? She comes in through that door, and she's so angry, right, that she has to go through all these people, and she finally found Bill. And then to realize that her daughter is alive, that change of expression is just, it's just pure genius. And the Superman line, and like the way he, you know, he didn't say he was jealous, but he used all these metaphors and his story with Superman and, you know, Spider-Man, Buddy as well, like the characters, there's so many characters in this. And you know, if you watch the most movies now, they use characters, these extra characters, the second characters, the third characters, the supporting actors and actresses, they use them as more of just like, you know, to fill a gap in the movie. But every single character in this mattered, like from Evita Green to Bill, right? Like, every single line was like fixed, like everything mattered, you know? Every single scene, like, from, like, you know, Pai Mei saying, this is my arm, right? And the fact that she went and killed every single one of these people and she took revenge, her best student took revenge with the arm that she, that Pai Mei taught her. It's just amazing, you know, from the wiggling your toe to like the rice, the grain of rice. I mean, the wordplay in this, like from the Black Mamba to, you know, to the kid saying, mom, like, die. It's, I can't tell you how good this movie is. Like, I'm so glad that I saw this movie. I mean, it's just, I'm lost for words. It's just pure perfection. Like, Tarantino, man, like, the guy, his mind is, it's just, imagine just if he could write like this. Oh, guys, I'm in love with this movie, everything about it, from Uma Thurman to the music, to the acting, to the script, to the love letter, to the Chinese cinema, to martial art movies. And you know how much I love my martial art movies. This movie is amazing. And now, do I think Kill Bill 2 is better than Kill Bill 1? Doesn't fucking matter. They're both amazing movies. You can't compare them because it's two different journeys, man. It's just pure perfection. To all of you, to all of you who, you could call me kiddo with my voice breaking. To all of you who recommended this movie, I love you. Thank you for, you know, watching my Kill Bill reactions. I hope you stay so we can watch more movies together. One grain at a time, one wiggle at a time. I fucking love you. Take care. Bang.